All right. I heard that they're going to try to start, well, Democrats are going to try to start euthanizing infants straight out the womb. All right. Now tell me this. What kind of people are we, seriously? I mean, are we demons? Are we devils? Or are we enlightened human beings? Or are we a mixture of everything? Because once we start killing our young and the way we're treating the elderly right now, we are on a path to doom. Okay? It's not a fucking joke. Okay? We're supposed to be the most intelligent species on this planet. And it seems like we're the most animalistic. Okay? Rules are supposed to separate us from the animals. And technically, it seems like we're becoming more animal than human anymore. Where are people's souls? Okay? That's what's killing me. This country is turning into a fucking cesspool of hell. You know? We make the world hell. Okay? There's no hell after we die or heaven after we die. It's hell on earth, here and now, okay? We can either make this paradise or we can make it hell. It's our choice. And right now, nobody seems to care about making it a paradise. Everybody just wants to make it hell. And when I say something like, Satan's really running this planet, Satan's really in control of this world, okay? People laugh and they think it's funny. Who the fuck do you think Satan is? Evil is intelligence and malevolence together. A tornado isn't evil. A hurricane isn't evil. A man is evil. A man is also intelligent and benevolent. That means we are gods. We are angels, okay? Humans have the potential for good and the potential for evil, okay? It's our call. It's whatever wolf we decide to feed the most, okay? So if we want to keep up feeding the damn evil, feeding the bad sides of ourselves, we're literally going to turn this place, this world, into a fucking hell. And that's exactly what we're doing now. There's going to be a literal hell on Earth, okay? We will literally have volcanism, nuclear bombs, any kind of heat, the weather, I mean, any kind of heat you can think of, any kind of hell you can think of, okay? Somebody's literally eventually going to set the thermostat to hell. And we are going to have to live that shit. And then it's going to be too damn late to make any fucking changes. Any changes. And then they're going to be like, oh, well, we need to start killing people to bone up on our supply. You know, look, we don't have a resource problem. We have a rich man wanting to hoard everything problem. And another friend told me that one. And it makes sense. So literally, if these rich men, if they actually cared, if they gave a shit, they would take these areas of land that's not being used and build neighborhoods and let people move into these neighborhoods to start producing, okay? I believe that Americans, not foreigners, Americans deserve a latitude and longitude. And if they have a latitude and longitude to become producers or contributors for the economy also, literally, people, citizens, can literally work from home and contribute to the economy. Everyone can have a higher standard of living, okay? We can revamp our country. We can revamp the way the government sits right now. We have the choice. Only we can do it. It takes us all working together. If we want the same thing, then we will get that same thing. We will get that. But we just have to work together. We have to get synchronized. These differences and petty squabbles, set the shit aside. We need to focus on our similarities, not our differences, okay? We live in a diverse world. This planet is very diverse. If you love your planet, love its diversity. Because that's what makes us human. That's what gives us the beautiful planet we live on. That's what gives us the beautiful life that we see on this planet. Diversity. We need diversity, okay? So if we can get on the same page and people can squash all their beefs when it comes to differences between everyone, then we can literally make this world a paradise. And this shit about killing unborn babies, I understand in a way, but at the same time, if we are going to promote going out and getting pregnant and just killing the baby when you don't want it, then men should not have to be forced to pay child support. If a female makes her choice to not accept her responsibilities, then a man should not be forced to accept responsibilities either, okay? He should want to take care of his child like a man, The woman should want to take care of her child like a woman, okay? People need to start meeting in the middle. There is a gray area. We live in a gray world. We do not live in a black or white world. This is a gray world. And we need to start seeing the gray. Just like with all this science and religion, okay? It's bound to have truth, okay? The religion is bound to have truth, or it wouldn't be there for thousands and thousands of years, okay? No lie literally survives that long. It's passed around until it dies, okay? Only truth can survive the ages, all right? It might diverge, but it has origins of truth, okay? It has a root of truth, all right? We just got to find out what that is. So religions are based off something true, which, in my opinion, which I found out, is ancient science, okay? Ancient physics. The theory of how the universe was formed. This is where these religions are based from, all right? This is when our ancients had technology and knowledge that we do not have now. They had understanding. They knew the nature of the universe. And that's one thing I'm trying to get out with this page, the nature of the universe. Because this truth can literally settle the differences between atheists and Christians. Believers literally can believe the truth that is right in front of them with facts. Atheists can see the fact that there's no God through facts, okay? It's all science. Science proves what the religious people believe, but in a different aspect. It proves what the atheists believe, but in a different aspect, okay? Everybody's correct, but there's certain stuff that they think is wrong. And all I'm trying to do is help that perspective. Because our perspective has diverged off the path so bad, it is causing nothing but hell on this planet. Like the word God, okay? The word of God, you know what the word of God is? God. Three letters. That's the word of God. G-O-D. That's the word, okay? The word God. The word of God can cause so many problems, okay? And it means that it's a nomenclature. And I'm just going to say, the quantum nature of the universe is what's God, okay? Alpha and Omega are nuclear and electric energy. Those predate the singularity, okay? So there is a before the singularity. There's a time before time. And if you want to know anything about physics, literally, I have a lot on my channel about physics. But I'm just asking that people can start opening their eyes. I know people are waking up, okay? And I'm just praying that people can actually get on the same page, okay? I really want my children to live in a world of peace. I want my children to grow up in a happy world, okay? All the stuff I see when it comes to people murdering children and all of this is just, it's unnecessary, okay? If they weren't raised in a world that's unhappy, they would have not gotten to that point, okay? Not to mention people that do get to that point and they hurt children or murder people just for the hell of it and they do it over and over and they're persistent, then these people do not deserve to live. They do not deserve to breathe on this planet, okay? What do you do with a sick animal? You put it out of its misery, all right? If a person does that stuff, they are a sick animal. They abandon their humanity, okay? They abandon their humanity. They gave that up. They knew the consequences. We need to start putting these consequences on them. What do they think when they do something like this? Oh, what's the government going to do? Give me 3 meals a day, 3 hots and a cot. I'll get to sit there and drink coffee all day long, play spades and all this, and sit there and at nighttime think about all the children I've hurt and reminisce about it. Look, those people do not deserve to think about those children, okay? Bad, negative thoughts about those children do not even need to exist anymore, okay? There's the only good from doing something like that, hurting these children, is in their heads. Eliminate them. Get that kind of hate and that kind of animal behavior off the fucking planet, okay? I'm just saying, this will free up economic money, this will help the resources that we claim are so low, okay? I mean, what are they doing? They're sitting in jail waiting to die? Look, I think it's more inhumane to let a sick animal live and then just cage them up, okay? But then people are like, oh, well, they need to sit there and live with what they did. Look, do you really think they care? No, they don't. They're going to live with it, yeah, and they're going to think about it and jerk off and whatever to it all the time. Okay, they're going to reminisce. They're going to revisit the past and think about when they did all this stuff, you know. They don't deserve to, you know. Just get rid of them. Like I've said, The Execution Network, executing criminals 24 hours a day for your viewing pleasure. All right? Sounds cold, sounds callous, but you know what? If we make an example out of these types of people, guess what? I would say that people would be less inclined to follow in those kind of footsteps. Okay? We live in a, as Wesley Snipes says on Demolition Man, a pussy-whipped, bready-bunch version of itself. And that's exactly what the world's become. A pussy-whipped, bready-bunch version of itself. Alright? We need to just get rid of them and start revamping shit. We need to fix this world. We need to unite ourselves. Okay? Because people want to bitch and moan about other countries. Oh, Islam this, Islam that, and Muslims this, Muslims that. You know? Are they killing little babies? Well, if they are, then we're no better. And if they don't, wow, maybe we should start doing what they're doing. Not killing babies. See? People are fucking hypocrites. I'm just saying. This world needs a fucking awakening. And we need to do that. It's going to take more than just one person. It's going to take a group of people. Technically, it only takes 1%. 1% of the Americans to make a change. 1%. I would say that'd be roughly 3 million people. Sounds like a lot, but when you consider the whole country, it's not really a lot.